They're boarding us.
So one day, my mom got an email from the Smithsonian saying that they want to feature one of my mermaid tails in one of their exhibits.
Right now, I'm making a silicone mermaid tail, and I'm airbrushing.
The second we heard that, we're like, holy crap. Like, this is a huge deal. The Smithsonian is one of the most famous museums out there. So instantly, I felt honored, and I was like, yes, of course we have to do this.
Hot, but at least there's some cool things to see.
Well, it's supposed to be about 107 degrees today here in Washington, D.C.
There is a heat wave going on. Like, it couldn't be any hotter.
Wait, so where's the Lincoln Monument? I want to go see Abraham Lincoln.
I want to go in that fountain.
Me too. I want to swim.
We're out here in the Lincoln Memorial.
Beautiful.
Yay!
My mom always loved taking videos, and I really found that passion in college to do the same, because it allows those memories to continue to exist in a virtual form.
Everyone just scream and jump in the air in the back of the video. Jazz, don't turn away.
I'm filming my family while we do all this stuff, because when we get back, Griffin's gonna head back to school, Ari's moving out, and Jazz is going soon too. So things are gonna change.
It's complicated.
It's all over the museum.
Oh my God, this whole museum is a big deal, Jazz. This is huge.
Knowing that Jazz is being highlighted in the Smithsonian, I mean, how surreal. Like, hello, am I living? Am I breathing? Did this happen? Is it a dream?
I could spend a whole day
here. Hello. How are you?
Great, welcome to the National Museum of American History. This is a long time coming.
Yes.
You all now get to see Girlhood. Mm-hmm. It's complicated, the exhibition.
I am just ecstatic. I'm so, so excited to see what the exhibit is gonna look like. I just feel so honored and blessed.
What we really wanted to do is basically have a fresh new take on women's history. And so the very first section is this one. I don't know if you recognize Naomi Wadler from March for Our Lives.
Of course.
And we thought it was really important to feature contemporary girls alongside important historical figures. This is actually one of my favorite cases. This is about Minnie Jean Brown's life and her efforts to desegregate a school in Little Rock, Arkansas.
Wow. Little Rock 9.
Yeah.
The exhibit is incredible.
Every single item that is in a museum has a story behind it, and a lot of work went into it. Just reading what was on the walls, seeing how far our country has gone and how far it still has to go was really profound for me.
Here's where you're gonna have a really great surprise, which you came to see right around the corner.
Okay, let's check it out.
It's gonna be pretty surreal to see myself in the Smithsonian. I have high hopes for the exhibit, but I still don't know exactly what it's gonna look like, so I'm really looking forward to seeing it.
Come on to the next section, what you came to see, a girl's life.
Oh my God! There it is. That's the tail. It looks so cool. And I love all the pictures. This is like, you could see exactly how I designed it based off of this picture. It is so crazy to be a part of an exhibit featuring all of these wonderful women, these wonderful girls who have changed history. To be featured as one of those people, it is flattery to the greatest extent.
You made that.
I made that at 12 years old, too. I've always been into mermaids. When I was a kid, I had mermaid Barbie dolls, and I made mermaid tails from fabric tails to silicone mermaid tails. It's really fascinating because a lot of other trans people are interested in mermaids, and it's cool because they have no genitalia. They just have this long, beautiful tail. So mermaids are kind of genderless, sexless, and it's really, really interesting how there is that sort of natural gravitation for a lot of trans people.
I don't know how you actually swam in this because it's so heavy.
It is really heavy out of the water, but once you get in the water, it's more buoyant.
You're such a little girl.
I know.
She made numerous of these. This isn't the only one.
I made a couple. I made like six or seven.
It's an unbelievable honor to know and see my sister is in the Smithsonian. And I'm at a loss of words for how my little sister has changed the world and how she's being recognized and honored for it.
I think the descriptions is the most powerful part of it all.
By embracing themselves, girls break barriers every day to change our culture's definitions of girlhood. For many, these rules just don't fit. Jazz Jennings is one of those girls. She shares her girlhood with millions of Americans and reminds us that girls can be assigned male at birth, that girlhood comes in many forms. High five for that. That's amazing.
The museum did a really great job of capturing the spirit of what jazz represents.
Oh, there's two sides.
Oh my goodness, there's so much stuff.
Ooh, all your art.
I think a lot of people see her as a symbol of great hope and forward thinking and progress and equality. Jazz definitely has made a mark on history.
As your parents, we are just, I know I can speak, I'm speechless. It just makes me really emotional.
Oh, so pretty. She's crying.
I am filled with so much joy and pride. I'm bursting. I've been waiting for years to see this. I mean, my kid is in a museum.
That's big stuff. That's really, you know, a proud moment for parents, definitely.
Say girl.